Hello, Oklahoma. Here I am with Larry Ross, and we are going to talk about the 0K. You had me at 0K. That's just my speed.
Just your speed?
Yeah. Okay. So this is a fundraiser for City Care.
It is.
Tell me all about it.
Well, a 0K is a run for the non-runners.
Yes.
It's a fundraiser for City Care, and we have several things that it will cover the funding for. But it's for people who would want to come out for an evening out at Crystal Lake and enjoy the best-kept secret in Oklahoma City at Crystal Lake and a fabulous evening. We have lots of things planned.
Mm-hmm. You've got food trucks, local breweries like Coop and whoever.
We got 6 or 7 food trucks coming out. We have 3 bands coming out. There'll be Mountain Smoke, a bluegrass band that has been around for a long time.
Yeah.
They're really good. A bunch of old guys that play great music.
And then a bunch of disco, Super Freaks.
Super Freaks are going to be there, and Lower 40.
Uh-huh.
Lower 40 are going to be there also. So it's going to be a great evening. Plus, we actually have, for those runners, a sanctioned 5K run on the new MAPS 3 trail that goes on the back side of Crystal Lake.
Okay, so you actually can run if you want to, but you don't have to. You can just run to the beer truck or whatever.
That's it. Or just bring your lawn chair and listen to the music.
Awesome. And so that is October 17th. Mm-hmm. It is a $25 donation for tickets.
Correct.
And then you can also form teams, raise money, and win great prizes.
That's right. If you go to 0kokc.com, that's how you can find out all the information on how to do it online. We have pop-up shops. We have a kids zone. The Oklahoma City Energy Soccer Club is going to manage that. So there's a lot. It's a family event, and it's going to be quite an evening. Really looking forward to it.
It sounds super fun, and this is going to be the second year you've done it. It's one of your biggest fundraisers.
It is.
That and your golf tournament, which is in April every year.
Our golf tournament. And it's interesting how 0K came to Oklahoma City.
Yeah.
If you'd like to hear that story real quick. Well, Patty Moore is our chairman of the board. She was in the Keys last year, and Patty, her idea of exercise is pulling the plug in the bathtub and fighting the current. She's never run in the 5K. She wanted the t-shirt. But she sees all these people coming to this 0K to go 800 foot over a bridge span.
Oh.
And it was for a fundraiser. And then that's exactly where we got the idea for Oklahoma City.
I love it.
Yeah,
that way it doesn't exclude anyone.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, let's back up for a second, because a lot of people aren't really aware of what City Care does, but you've got just a handful of really amazing programs. How did it start? You founded it 20 years ago?
Well, 22 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, Steve Zabel, teammate of mine at OU, long, long time ago.
Played for OU, Barry Switzer.
Steve just got nominated and elected to the Oklahoma Sports Hall of Fame. But we started serving a breakfast to the homeless 5 days a week at 10th and Robinson. Mm-hmm. It's now Frontline Church, it was City Church. And then from that, we decided that to raise a little money to buy the food, we would start City Care, which we did. West Lane was one of our originally fundraisers and founding members.
Great guy.
Then from that, we were very involved in the Murrah bombing because we were so close to the building.
Yeah.
And so the YMCA was never replaced. So we raised money with the city's help, and we built the Pershing Center, which is transitional housing.
Mm-hmm.
We have 60 rooms. You can stay there for up to 2 years. And if you've stayed there with case management that we have and in-house drug testing, all that, and we're 92% employed there also, because
mm-hmm.
we find people jobs.
Oh, so the residents, 92% of them are employed.
It's a back-to-work program.
Right.
And if you've done well there, then you have a chance to move into one of our 32 duplexes, our 12 houses, all bills paid, fully furnished. That's homeless, transitional housing, and then permanent housing.
That is just so cool. Tell me about WizKids.
Well, WizKids is to break the cycle of illiteracy that we see in Oklahoma. We hear about that all the time. You hear about the reading scores and the testing problems that they're having in the elementary schools and above. But WizKids is designed strictly to focus on reading and uses the faith community working with inner city schools, Title I schools, and that's all but 2, and they work with these kids one-on-one for reading. We have 30 schools we work with now, 900 tutors, about 1,200 volunteers,
wow.
And we feed the kids at every site. We train the tutors for a one-on-one paired reading, and it's been a very, very, our 20th year. and very, very successful program.
That's amazing. You told me earlier that you serve 8,500 meals every month?
Well, at the day shelter, we manage the Oklahoma City Day Shelter. We work with the Homeless Alliance. And this campus has the resource center with the Homeless Alliance run with, that has the resources, mental illness, women with children, all of health care. We do the shelter part. We do breakfast and lunch. We do about 8,500 meals a month now, haircuts, showers, case management. It's really something that Oklahoma City could be proud of.
Yeah.
Love for you to come see that.
Oh, yeah. You're really an inspirational guy. What is it? Is there just something in your heart that just led you this way? What was it that motivated you?
It was when I was doing that breakfast. I was always a bootstrap mentality. If you want to get out of this situation, all you have to do is get a job. That's what I used to think, mm-hmm. until I started listening and hearing the stories and then seeing the pervasiveness of mental illness and addiction in Oklahoma City and everywhere in all cities and small towns too. But, you know, one thing after another, and just I guess the Lord would open up a door here and there, and we just were able to walk through it, and we're still plugging away.
Well, it's awesome work you guys are doing. I'm so impressed and thankful, really. You know, the city is just in need of more people like you. So thank you for coming in. Go online to zerokokc.com to register for the 0K run. And I guess you could just show up and pay there, right?
Exactly. Well, yeah. There'll be a lot. It's a sanctioned race. It's a sanctioned 5K. So there'll be a lot of runners that show up that day. And we'll stay for the bands, and I think they'll enjoy the evening.
A good time for a good cause. So, all right, well, Larry, great seeing you. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you very much, Heather.
You bet.